everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Back to Basics. So on the first episode we talked about how to properly read a magic card, and now I think it's time to talk a bit about colors, the colors that magic has, because it would be wrong to go directly into deck building without knowing what the colors are and what each color does and what's the meaning of each color. White is the color of order, light and healing. It has many small creatures. Many big creatures, like angels. You can also find knights. Soldiers. Clerics. That protect the weak and injured. The flavor of white is the color of protection, defense, healing, can be cruel, it can destroy everything. Some main abilities white has are vigilance, non-lethal killing, which means, for example, the card pacifism, that it can constrict a card from doing its thing. Has combat reaction that can pump up its creatures with instant or protect them. Lifelink. Now let's talk a bit about black. It's a simple color. Its purpose is to win, and to win by all means necessary, even if it has to destroy itself in order to do that. It can get very aggressive. It will clear your path for new creatures to come and attack. Some abilities of black are creature removal, you can draw cards with the cost of life, It has fear. Discard. Pump up creatures according to the number of swamps you control. Of course, you have life gain on some creatures. Also life drain. You have tutoring. Regeneration. Death touch. And reanimation. Of course, you have land destruction. Assassin. Cleric, Demon, Horror, Vampire, Zombie, and Spectre. Of course, there are more, but those are the most common. And it's time to talk about red. So red is the most aggressive color. It has a lot of small creatures. And it also has big and huge creatures. Some abilities of red are direct damage, for instance. Temporarily take control of opponent's creatures. Enhancing creatures. Your opponent can't block some creatures. It also has haste. Trample. First strike, double strike. Land destruction and artifact destruction. Some creature types you can build with red are goblin, ogre, dragon, minotaur, Orc, Elemental, Giant. Blue is the color of manipulation. It has many counter spells. It has many flyers. Card draw, so you can have an advantage. A few abilities of blue are bounce, you can bounce cards. Restricting other players to draw cards. Of course, milling. Stealing creatures. You also have cannot untap. You have a lot of tapping and untapping. Of course, you have mana drain. Some creature tribes you can build with blue are merfolk, wizard, drake, illusion, sphinx, and bird. Of course, there are others. Green is the color of life and nature. Green focuses on making its creatures larger in order to beat your opponents with brute force. You can destroy artifacts or enchantments. You can increase dramatically your mana production. Green also has apple. Some creature types you can build with green are elf, human, troll, wolf, worm, druid, beast, insect, spider. I hope you found this episode useful. It's very important to get to know those things, get to know what each color does before you go into deck building, because you need to have a synergy in your deck. If you don't, it will be a random deck with random creatures and no interaction between them. generally good to know what each color does so you can see and predict what your deck will do according to what game style you want to play with. For example, if you play vampires, you're gonna have a tribe deck with vampires that's focused on life drain and life gain and that sort of stuff. Thank you for watching, guys. I will see you on the next one.